4, 3, 2, 1.
Yo, mic check, mic check.
The top 5 at 5 on today's trending stories.
Hey. Let's get it going.
The top 5 at 5 on the smooth drive.
Listening to Smooth 98.1, Love Music, Love Life. When you hear that sound, you know it's time for Top 5 at 5.
Top 5, Top 5.
Yes, indeed. My name is Judith at TV.
I'm Katie Baker.
And you should know that the Top 5 trending stories, or better so, Top 5 is just about Top 5 trending stories or stories making the rounds today. We share them with you. It's it touches on pretty much every topic, and it's from all around the world, Africa, Europe, Asia. We just bring them to you, right? So remember that you can, you know, join the conversation and send your WhatsApp messages to 0809-444-0981. You can send your analysis, comments, or just, you know, share your thoughts with us on the stories as we share today.
That's right. Let's start off with what's happening here in Nigeria. And this one is shocking. And do you know why it's shocking to me? Because it's shocking because
you're naive.
No, not naive now. It's a big number, but we trivialize things like this in Nigeria. Yeah, trivialize is the word I'm looking for. So 888 people were killed in Kaduna State in 9 months.
Say that again. Say the numbers again.
888 people were killed in Kaduna State in 9 months. This is according to the state government, right? Okay, so they're saying, now, according to the story, it says at least, now it could be more, right? At least 888 people were killed in violent attacks carried out in various parts of Kaduna State in the last 9 months. Now, this was captured in quarterly security reports presented by the state government from the report. A total of 343 people were killed by bandits between... Now, listen to this. A total of 343 people were killed by bandits between July and September. This year alone, 2,553 people were kidnapped by bandits in various communities across the state from January to September 2021. Now, the Kaduna State Commissioner for Internal Security and Home Affairs, Samuel Aruan, who presented the report during an enlarged security meeting on Wednesday, you know, attributed the deaths to kidnappings, banditry, communal clashes, violent attacks, and reprisals that cut across all ethnic and religious groups in the state. Now, Governor Nasir El-Rufai sympathized with the victims of the attacks and ordered an immediate compensation for surviving victims and relatives of the deceased. Now, I want to know this. What will the compensation do for the families, right? What kind of how do you even compensate a person that lost, you know, his child, that lost everything?
Mm-hmm.
We're talking communal clashes, we're talking banditry, we're talking, you know, kidnapping, right? And we're saying it like, I mean, we're just mentioning it so casually, like, mm-hmm. you know, 888 people died, you know, in one place. I'd like to see the reports from Borno State, from Abia State, from Adamawa, from Lagos. I'd like to see the reports from those places, because it's as though we don't value lives in this country. It's not even as though we don't value lives in this country. You know, there's so, and yesterday is a clear indication, for example.
Kyrie, just don't bring that
you
up
know?
Again.
So we need to open our eyes in this country. And the best thing we should do is, we've been talking about this for the longest time. You know, there's a saying that the middle class, you know, the upper class generally, they always talk about change, but they don't ever do anything. They talk about it, but they don't try to make change happen. So if you don't own a PVC, and this is just my 2 cents for the story, try and get one. We can actually make things happen, make things different in 2023. Yes, there's a lot that goes on in terms of elections, rigging, amongst other things. But if you want the right candidate to be there, let's vote the right person in so we can tackle these situations. This is very, I mean, it's, being in Nigeria is scary. You know, there was a travel advisory that was released just last week, or was it a couple of days ago,
mm-hmm.
that talked about states that, you know, people from different countries should not visit. And it's shocking. It's scary because out of 36 states, when you have 30 states out of 36 states, mm-hmm. then you know that there's a problem. There's a serious problem.
Mm. Well, speaking of more on this, I'm going to take this story. I shouldn't have, but I just saw it and I've just been mind blown as well. But first, this message is from Danny JY and it goes, cause of traffic on Anthony Bridge, and it says traffic from Ostrady merging with those from Yaba Access under the Anthony Bridge on Ikorodu Road. LASMA officials helping out as always. Also, some connecting back to the Ostrady Bridge via Ostrady Road via under the bridge. So that's what's causing that traffic. So thank you so much, Danny JY, for that. So yeah, let's get into it, shall we? So like, it's bad enough that transportation in the state is just really wild. The roads are not safe. Is either there are potholes or there's accidents or kidnapping. Well, this recent development is another stir to the pot of soup. And I don't know the analogy to use as I use that one, because the pot of soup is already brewing. So this is just another ingredient added to it. The Nigerian Railway Corporation has suspended indefinitely. Indefinitely train services along the Abuja-Kaduna route. And this is in a statement on its website. On Thursday, the services were suspended for the safety of passengers and crew members. It, however, added that efforts were being put in place to ensure absolute safety along the route. How do you do that when you suspend that? Help me understand that. And going on to say that, meanwhile, former lawmaker and political commentator Shehu Sani has asserted that bandits attacked the Kaduna Abuja train on Wednesday night. And in a statement on social media, he said the bandits planted an explosive that damaged the rail train, the rail track, and shattered the windshield of the train engine. According to him, they also opened fire, targeted the driver and the tank. It happened between Duse and Rijana stations. The driver's struggled to move towards Kaduna Rigasa station. And he goes on to say, and he said he was on board Thursday when the train conveying him and other passengers ran over another explosive damaged railings, causing it to almost skid off its paths. The ex lawmaker called on authorities to suspend operations until the issue is addressed. And so
I hope they don't set up a committee to look into the matter now, because now that's what we're going to hear. We'll set up a committee to look into the matter, and then it will spiral into months as well. So this is really bad. The rate of insecurity in this country, it's alarming, it's shocking, and something needs to be done about that. But away from that, let's talk about what's happening with Donald Trump. He's back in the news again, and in a way, this put a smile on my face, because I'm curious. I want to see the end of it, right? I want to see how far this can go. Now, Donald Trump has launched his own social media company, and it's called Truth Social. Yep, with a capital T. Okay, so according to the story, Trump's media company, Trump Media and Technology Group, they've merged with the Digital World Acquisition Corp to become a publicly listed company with a potential valuation of up to $1.7 billion. Now, the former president announced that Truth Social is set to launch in early 2022 to compete with the likes of Facebook and Twitter, the two sites that have banned his accounts. Now, Trump also announced that he will launch a subscription video on demand service to rival Google's YouTube. Wow, this is even more interesting, right? And according to Trump, the move is a fulfillment of a promise to create a conservative media competitor to combat the liberal activism against the administration, against his administration, and the 2020 presidential campaign. So, you know what? I see sanctions flying everywhere. You know, the government also might want to shut this down if it contravenes to something. But I'm curious to see how people are going to accept this Truth Social media and how they're going to ride with it. I know that that China wouldn't take it.
This is a severe case of gaslighting. You know, when they found over and over again that, sure, I've always said it before, that
so
I'm
he
not
needs
gonna
a platform.
Pull my energies.
He needs a platform to put his own thoughts out. And he's generally, this is what money does to you, or does for you. You know, he's then created a platform where he can say everything he wants to say, and all his followers are going to go down there, you know, to well.
I just.
This is quite interesting. Interesting times ahead.
I know. But anyway, moving on to sports, and this time it's tennis. Novak Djokovic will not be able to enter Australia to defend his Australian Open title unless he's fully vaccinated for COVID-19. The country's immigration minister said yesterday, putting the Serbian Grand Slam record bid in doubt. Now, world number one, Djokovic, who is level with Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal on 20 Grand Slam titles, has declined to reveal his vaccination status and said he's unsure if he will defend his Australian Open crown. Clarifying Australia's visa requirements, the Minister for Immigration, Alex Hawke, said foreign players would need to have had two vaccination shots to play the Grand Slam at Melbourne Park in January. And he says, and I quote, "You would need to be double vaccinated to visit Australia. That's a universal application, not just to tennis players. I mean that every visitor to Australia will need to be double vaccinated. I don't have a message to Novak. I have a message to everyone that wishes to visit Australia. He will need to be double vaccinated." So let's see how that plays out. If he's going to come, if it's not going to come.
I think he might want to defend that title, so he'll be vaccinated. But then again, I don't know. The distance, the time. Not the distance now, the time, you know. We'll see. We'll see if he can do it. Hmm. Because I don't know his stance on vaccinations, amongst other things. But then again, the Australian Open is just around the corner, yes?
Yes. And a funny thing is, more than a third of professional players remain unvaccinated, and this is according to recent media reports. Both the men's ATP and women's WTA tours have urged players to get vaccinated, but some have voiced reservations. And I'm confused. You guys, I mean, athletes are one of
the
persons.
Voices, the faces of the
and
people.
It's not just the voices. They're the ones who will try any, you know, medical trials when it comes to, you know,
improving themselves,
you know. So why wouldn't you get vaccinated? I just don't get it. Anyway, just moving on.
Final story real quick, though. Let's talk about Ansu Fati, right? He's with Barcelona, of course, if you didn't know this. He signed a six-year deal with £1 billion buyout clause amid fears that he could be lured by rivals next summer. Now, when I saw this, I mean, I was shocked, right? And I'm like, wait, is Ansu Fati that good? So he's 18 years old, right? He's broken a number of records. And, you know, Barcelona actually thinks that he might actually be the next Lionel Messi because they've given him the number 10 jersey. And so far, he's doing well. He's made a total of 47 appearances for Barcelona. He scored 15 goals already. He scored his first Champions League goal against Inter Milan at the age of 17. He's just 18, remember that, right? The forward has also broken a series of records, including becoming the youngest ever Barcelona player to score in La Liga, score at Camp Nou, and also play in the Champions League. Now, I think he made his debut for the first team in 2019 at the age of 16. So this is why there's so much premium that's placed on Ansu Fati. But 6 years, though, I don't know. And Barcelona, to be honest, they look like the shadow of themselves. They've lost all the big stars. They're struggling. And it feels like they're not what they're not who they used to be. But if you think I'm wrong, feel free to correct me. Let's have that conversation. Once again, it's 0809-444-0981. That's our top five at five.
Top five. Join us right next for brain freeze.
Smooth
health on the drive. And it's brought to you by Evercare Hospital. Okay, so join us then. We have a special doctor coming in the studio. And we're going to be talking about preventive medicine. Okay, so please join us.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yo, mic check.
The top five at five on today's trending stories.
Hey. Let's get it going.
The top five at five on the smooth drive. Every weekday from 5 p.m.
Love music. Love life.
There are moments in life when you're just so scared and you feel like just giving up. You can do it, believe in yourself and then go for it. Go for it. Nourish mental. That is your Dino Milk. Oh yes, Dino Milk. Dino Milk. Drink up your Dino Milk. Dino Milk.
True love, they say, is hard to find.
Get away from me.
But what happens when the one you found is bound with complications?
No one can love the beast who slept with my sister in full view of anyone in this house, damn it.
Tune in to watch the brand new Africa Magic original, Dilemma, showing weekdays at 8 p.m. on Africa Magic Showcase, channel 151 on DSTV.
With Airtel Home Broadband device, your home is connected and you all can focus on the important things in life. Enjoy the finer things in life in the Airtel HBB seasonal offer. Visit any certified Airtel shop to get a 4G MiFi at 9,999 Naira plus up to 55 gigabyte bonus data, or router at 19,999 Naira plus up to 160 gigabyte bonus data. Offer valid while stock lasts. Terms and conditions apply.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
Wanna play a game?
Yes.
When it's game time, it's fun time. And when it's fun time, it's kids time. Because kids think the darnest things.
Because it's not magic.
Like inventing the future time machine or flying to the moon with just a cape on.
So I could discover new lands.
The Smooth 98.1 Studios presents Curious Minds as we explore the wonder world of today's kids.
I want to be an astronaut,
shoe designer,
fortune teller,
an entrepreneur.
Hear what they hear, see what they see, and know what they know.
A something something majinga.
Curious Minds. Every Saturday from 8:40 a.m.
That's all, folks.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right.
That helps raise people's awareness.
Get health information and tips for optimal well-being.
How to prevent it, detect or treat it.
This is Smooth Health on the Drive.
Smooth 98.1, love music, love life. Welcome to Smooth Health on the smoothest dial on Lagos Radio. And if you just joined us, well, you are just in time. We're going to be having a very interesting conversation today that talks about, everything that you should be aware of. It centers around preventive health and its role in overall health. And we would love for you to join us, okay? Plus, we're giving our vouchers on the show today to the first three callers or texters. And, of course, you know what to do. If you don't know what to do, let's tell you what to do. You have to reach out to us on 0809-444-0981 to be part of our conversation, to get your thoughts in. That's for WhatsApp. And also, you can call us on 01-44-89-981 for voice calls.
Yes, indeed. Let's get started, shall we? So today's topic is preventive medicine, its role in your overall health, and its role in your overall health. And today we have a very special guest joining us today to have that, to help us shed light on what preventive medicine is Dr. Enaholo Odia. And he's a consultant family physician with Evercare Hospital, Lekki. He is charged with providing specialist primary care for the teeming undifferentiated differentiated patients that present to Evercare hospitals. His role also includes overseeing and managing the Evercare and Wellness Clinic. Those roles he maintains according to the hospital values and international best practices for excellent service and growth. Prior to Evercare Hospitals Lekki, he had worked as a primary care physician with about 13 years of clinical experience at varying health institutions. Previous roles have been with multiple disciplinary teams and rotations in varying medical specialties. Highly patient-centered, intellectually sound, and teamwork-driven, with experience in care of the elderly, infectious and non-communicable diseases, hospice and palliative medicine, adolescent medicine, and lifestyle medicine. He holds a MBBS from the University of Benin, and he is a fellow of the West African College of Physicians. He's also a member of Society of Family Physicians of Nigeria, that's SOFPAN, SOFPON, I beg your pardon, and also member World Organization of National Colleges, Academics, and Academic Associations of Family Physicians. That's quite a resume, sir.
Quite the resume.
Thank you very much.
Hello, sir. Let's say that again. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Good to have you here. You've got quite the resume.
Quite the resume. go ahead, Kaede.
Okay, so yes, if you're out there, don't forget we told you at the start of the show, join us. We're giving 10,000 naira vouchers courtesy our sponsors, Evercare Hospital, and we'd love for you to, you know, send your questions in to our doctor today.
So, doctor, let's start with the basics, okay? So what is preventive medicine?
Thank you once more for having me on this program. Preventive medicine, as the name implies, basically means to prevent disease or any act a doctor performs or healthcare practices that promote health and prevent disease. So it's actually a specialty, which is a very recent specialty, and medical science is actually focusing on preventive health currently.
All right.
So it summarizes what preventive medicine stands for.
Okay, so I'd like that you've, you know, given us a breakdown of what that is. But now I'd like to, you know, open this up a little bit further, right? Yeah. What is the purpose of preventive medicine?
The goal of preventive medicine is to promote health and well-being and prevent disease.
Yes. Okay, so generally that's the goal, right?
Yes.
So what's your first call of action, for example? Give us an example and like an idea.
Preventive medicine, it's quite encompassing. It involves a lot of aspects to it. A major aspect of preventive medicine is education.
Okay.
Education of the patient. You have to tell them practices and actions which they perform in their daily lives that are detrimental to their health. Actions they just do passively. Smoking, alcohol use, sedentary lifestyle, poor exercise habits, all these are actions that lead eventually to non-communicable diseases like hypertension, diabetes, obesity, and the education of the patient in this aspect can help prevent these diseases or prevent them from developing. Another major aspect of preventive health or preventive medicine, it's immunization. Which protects against infection.
It's a good thing you mentioned immunization, because I mean this actually now sits home. It rings a big bell.
Big bell when it comes to vaccination and just the populace and the refusal to get vaccinated against the virus.
Yeah. So immunization, it's a huge aspect of it, and it deals with giving vaccines that will help prevent infectious diseases. The commonest one that comes to our mind currently.
Polio. Or COVID.
Exactly, COVID. Yes. Yeah.
So no, I mentioned polio because I think for a while now, right, Nigeria had been ravaged by polio. And I think some studies have shown that, you know, it's drastically reduced because people are becoming more aware of it. But it's good that, you know, preventive medicine is one of the things that tackles that situation. Because for a long time, I think back in the day, well, before the modern era, people were not aware generally that, you know, vaccines were needed to tackle that situation.
Exactly. You're very correct. Nigeria used to be one of the countries that had polio endemic in it. Nigeria has recently declared polio free just because of the wide coverage,
yes,
from vaccination for polio vaccine. So we have less occurrences of the wide polio viruses and polio infection, which was what was ravaging a lot of kids, a lot of unvaccinated children in the past. But right now we are polio free, and it's one of the key pillars of preventive medicine.
Hopefully one day we'll say one day we're COVID-free too. But yeah.
Hopefully.
Okay, so speaking on preventive medicine. Now, I'd like to know this, and I'm sure our listeners out there would like to know this as well. Who practices preventive medicine?
Thank you very much for your question. Preventive medicine, like I mentioned earlier, it's a fairly new specialty. In some countries in the West, United States, for example, it's known as a specialty. We have preventive medicine physicians.
Okay.
Just like you have obstetricians, you have family physicians, you have orthopedic surgeons. You have preventive medicine physicians. And the core of their job includes some of the things I mentioned earlier. But in our climb, in Nigeria especially, family physicians take that role. Other physicians as well, because preventive medicine or prevention in medicine can be categorized into primary prevention, secondary prevention, tertiary prevention. We have other categories which I wouldn't mention in these are discussed this afternoon. But so because of the role of a physician, for example, in tertiary prevention, you have other specialties that would act as practitioners in preventive medicine. The cardiologist, for example, the gastroenterologist, for example. So every physician is a practitioner of preventive medicine.
All right. Thank you so much for that, Doctor. If you just joined us, you're listening to Smooth 98.1. We are the smoothest style of Lagos radio. You can be a part of our conversation today. Please reach out to us on 0809-444-0981. As you might have noticed, we're discussing preventive medicine, its role in your overall health, okay? And, of course, our very special guest is Dr. Enaholo Odia. Yes? And he's, of course, talking to us about our role in preventive medicine. Okay, so once again, 0809-444-0981 is where you can send your messages to. Got a message here from Frank from Berger. He says, good evening, doctor. Please explain the benefits of taking the COVID vaccine. I learned it doesn't stop you from getting the virus. It doesn't stop you from spreading the virus if infected. It only reduces the effect on you if infected. Please clarify. Secondly, why is there a mandate to take the vaccine since it's all about personal protection? Shouldn't it be a strictly voluntary exercise? Okay, so Frank, well, this is quite the lengthy one, but since we're on the, you know, table of preventive medicine, doctor.
Thank you, Frank, for the input you just brought in, and I would approach it this way. I'll talk about the mandate first. Science is what you see from actions of putting one or two things together, and eventually you get a result. And science has proven that the vaccines work. Vaccines prevent diseases. Vaccines prevent, there are numerous diseases vaccines are known to prevent, and COVID is one of them. COVID vaccine helps prevent the disease. It helps prevent you having a serious infection,
okay,
and that would eventually lead to death. So the vaccines are something that will be prescribed by any practitioner of medicine for you not to get the COVID infection. So vaccines are something that are supported. And we're talking about preventive health today. So vaccine is something I would go all out. Yeah, I'll go all out to recommend. Talking about the mandate, I'll liken that to you driving a car and wearing your seatbelt. It's mandated for you to wear your seatbelt when you drive, just to protect you. And the government of the day, the government has seen that it's important. It's not, the mandate has not been fully enforced in Nigeria, but some states, I understand, have started that. Some government agencies have started the mandate. It's just to help the people and protect the people. It's still it's a thin line. It's a thin line because people see it as a voluntary thing, and people still see it as if the government is forcing them to take this vaccine. But the government is just trying to protect the populace, which is one of the core functions of the government.
All right. Thank you
very
so much
good,
for that.
Very good informed response there. Doctor, tell us about the importance of preventive medicine.
Preventive medicine, it's so important in our lives that it helps us not come down with diseases,
okay,
as we would have, because you probably would have taken an immunization, you probably would have stopped smoking, that would have prevented you from having lung cancer, or you probably would have cut down on your alcohol use, that would have stopped you from developing cardiovascular disease, or developing diabetes. So at the end of the day, you don't spend so much on your health.
Okay.
So preventive medicine is a cheaper route to being healthy compared to you developing the disease and ending up in the hospital and having complications that would impact on your person, impact on the family if you're a breadwinner, impact on the society and the government at large.
I like the fact that you mentioned it's a cheaper route. Now, because, I mean, a lot of people, you know, are looking for ways to, you know, just try and stay away from the hospital for long periods. And
exactly.
Preventive medicine is, you know, that way to go, definitely.
Exactly.
Okay, so we're still taking phone calls. So if you're out there and you want to, you know, send a question or a message to our doctor, feel free to do that. 01448 9981. I'll say that again. 01448 9981. Ugati sends a funny message, but we'll get to that later. Also, I've got this question I'd like to ask you, doctor. I'd like to know about the role of preventive medicine, especially in developing countries, particularly here in Nigeria.
Yeah, developing countries has its role, and preventive medicine, like I mentioned, it's fairly new. It's a practice we are encouraging all health practitioners to embrace. And Nigeria has a high disease burden, especially for infectious disease. So prevention or teaching methods to prevent this disease will be very, very helpful. That's the commonest infectious disease we have in our climate is malaria, for example. So use of insecticide-treated nets, clearing of drains, clearing of swarms or bushes around you, early treatment when you start seeing the signs, are all forms of prevention. And these are some of the practices we encourage now, as against coming down with the disorder and treating, which will cost you more. So it's a practice we'll all encourage. In Evercare hospitals, for instance, it's part of our core practices. We have a health and wellness clinic where we encourage patients, not necessarily patients, even people who are well, because it's a health and wellness clinic.
True.
You come and do some screening, and this helps you to be able to detect if you have any disorder, any infection on time, and which can be nipped in the bud early. apart from this, you are provided with a physical examination. The examination goes through all your systems and tells you if there are any issues.
What you should be aware of.
Exactly. And you'll be surprised that some people who are not aware that they are hypertensive are picked up during these clinics. Hypertension, like we all know, is a silent killer.
Yeah.
It comes with no sign. And it's only when your blood pressure is measured before that can be detected. So apart from that, we give you education during this wellness clinic, and it helps. It just helps you more armed to be able to take care of your health.
All right. If you just joined us, you're listening to Smooth Health right here on Smooth 98.1. Of course, we're talking about preventive medicine on the show, and we'd love for you to be a part of our conversation. But first, we need to go on a quick break. When we get back, we'll do some more talking. Stay with us.
Smooth Health on the Drive.
It's a global observation that helps raise people's awareness.
Insightful tips and information to live in a healthier and happier life.
How to prevent it, detect or treat it.
Smooth Health is powered by Evercare Hospital, Lekki. Transforming healthcare in Nigeria.
If you didn't know, now you know.
This is Smooth Health on the Drive. Simple rules for driving safely around Lagos. Did you know that regulatory signs are mostly circular in shape and are of two types? Those with blue circles but no red border are mandatory signs. They give positive instructions and are regulatory signs.
This is Lagos.
This is Smooth Health on the Drive.
It's a global observation that helps raise people's awareness.
Smooth Health is powered by Evercare Hospital, Lekki. Transforming healthcare in Nigeria.
Love music, love life. Welcome back. If you just joined us, of course, we're still talking about preventive medicine, and you're welcome to be a part of our conversation. We see messages, or we've taken messages already from Frank and also Ugati. And if you want to be a part of our conversation, you want to understand what preventive medicine really is all about, then now is the best time to send your questions in.
Yes, send them in to 0144. You can call us, by the way, that's our telephone line, to 01448 9981. Again, 01448 9981. You can also send us a WhatsApp message to 0809 444 0981. We're talking about preventive medicine and its role that it plays when it just comes to patient medicine here in just overall health care or overall health here in Nigeria. That's what we're talking about today. And we have a guest today from Evercare Hospital, Dr. Enaholo Odia, and we're having that conversation today when it comes to preventive medicine. All right, so if you have any questions, any comments, please call us up, and you stand a chance to win 10,000 naira worth of voucher, and that goes to your very first consultation fee at Evercare Hospital. So, Doctor, we've talked about the importance. We'll talk about, you know, who practices preventive medicine, a little bit about the purpose of preventive medicine, and even, you know, the basics. But giving out climb, right, Nigeria. Just, oh, we have a call there. Let's see who this caller is, if we can take that call. Sorry, doctor, let's see who this is. Hello?
Yeah, hello?
Yes, good evening.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening. How you doing?
I'm fine.
All right, your name, sir?
My name is Frank. I'm calling from Amuwa Dofi.
Okay, Frank, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm very much concerned about the conversation. It's a nice one. But what I am very bad at it is about the governmental approach to this vaccine.
All right, we're not talking about vaccines, sir, unfortunately. We're talking about preventive medicines. So if you have any questions about that, we'd prefer for you to discuss that. I think the doctor shed enough light on the COVID-19 vaccines.
Okay. Is that right?
Thank you
so much, Frank.
All right. So, doctors, I was talking about just basically, what are some common diseases that you've screened for preventive medicines, like in that kind of in the department? Some of the common diseases, given out a climb, that you normally see in the field.
Thank you very much.
Some of the common diseases we encounter, which are screened, includes cardiovascular diseases. The commonest of the cardiovascular diseases will be hypertension, which is endemic in our society. Diabetes mellitus, it's equally another very common disorder, which we easily screen at Evercare hospitals. Infectious diseases, cancers are currently on the rise, especially in this part of the world, and are also screened in Evercare hospitals. So these are some of the disorders which can be screened. Others will include thyroid disorders, abdominal disorders that can easily be screened by just coming to do a simple test. It could be a blood test, it could be a urine test, but it can be screened. In the past, we were not able to have access to cancer marker screening. But at Evercare hospitals, we can screen for, we have over 5 cancer markers, which can tell you that, oh, there's a possibility
of you having cancer in the future, or having it in your genes.
Yeah, then for the female folks, we screen for breast cancer, we screen for cervical cancer. So if you're over 40, you're eligible to do a mammography. And for females as well, they can do a coming for a pap smear, which will help screen for cervical cancer. And the early screening and detection helps curb the disease, because if the cells are picked up, there are approaches that will be taken that will help stop the disease in its track.
Nice.
All right. Thank you so much for that, Doctor. I'm glad you mentioned that, you know, some of the things that you screen and you quickly, you know, shed a spotlight on likes of hypertension, diabetes, you know, cancers, because like you mentioned, they're on the rise here.
Exactly.
But I want to circle back a little bit and talk about the benefits of this. Now, I want to know, who are the people that benefit generally from preventive medicine? I know that it covers a wide range of things, right? But it's also important to know direct benefits, or people generally benefit from preventive medicine.
Okay, I'll classify them into the age of the patient.
Okay.
Babies, for instance, infants who get immunization, protected from varying infections, poliomyelitis like we talked about, whooping cough, tuberculosis, hepatitis B. All these are childhood vaccinations that are given from birth till the child, as the child goes through infancy.
Yes.
Measles. These were diseases and disorders that were killers in the past. A child who, for instance, doesn't get vaccination for tuberculosis, usually would not, if he gets infected with TB, doesn't live up to 5 years. Just recently, we got news from WHO that there's a vaccine for malaria.
Yes.
And
that's great news.
That will be included. So you can imagine what that will do to the disease burden of malaria. So for children, vaccination, it's one benefit they can get that will help prevent diseases that would have taken almost half of all the children that were born.
Yes.
For the elderly patients as well, there are screening that can be done for them. A blood pressure can be checked, blood sugar can be checked to tell if they are diabetic, to tell if they are hypertensive. The cancer screenings I talked about are equally things that can be done for elderly people. So these are benefits that can be accrued from coming for early screening from detection of whatever disorder that they might be exposed to. Because the truth of the matter is that our environment and our lifestyle exposes us to so many irritants that can cause disease.
Got a message here from Jay, but before we get into that message, real quick though, I'd like to, you know, unbundle some of this thing that you talked about now and break it down for the layman out there. All right, so you talked about vaccination, you know, for babies and screenings for adults, right? Is there a possibility, and you talked about, you know, the exciting one, the vaccinations now for malaria. So is it, although it's not or cast in stone. But is all these vaccinations you talked about, are they, could they still be applied for adults, or does it stop at just infants and babies?
Yeah, we have vaccines for adults. Hepatitis B infection, for instance,
okay,
which can be sexually transmitted.
Mm-hmm.
It's completely protected from a vaccine.
Okay.
So you take the vaccine, so that protects an adult.
Mm.
Other adult vaccines that can be given includes the influenza vaccine.
Yeah.
Influenza, it's especially in elderly people, they come down with chest infections. Pneumococcal vaccine is equally another vaccine for adults as well. So these are some of the vaccines. And our COVID vaccine for adults.
The notorious
as well.
COVID vaccine.
Yes.
So these are vaccines that can be used for adults.
Mm.
In regions where meningitis is prone, the meningitis belt, which Nigeria is a part of, especially the northern part of this country,
mm-hmm,
the meningococcal vaccine is equally provided. So that gives protection to adults as well.
Mm.
All right. Like I mentioned, we got messages from Jay and also a couple of other people. But basically, you can call us on 01-44-89-981. Jay says, good evening, doctor. Please explain the benefits of taking... okay. All right. okay, sorry. I think I was reading Frank's message earlier. He says, hi, guys. When it comes to preventive medicine, for most people, what comes to mind is, if it isn't broken, why fix it? In terms of spending money on screening and diagnostic tests, how's Evercare working with the public health agencies in doing health teachings around preventive measures against diseases? And this is Bolaho. Jay Bolaho.
That's a very good question.
Thank you very much, Bolaho. Just recently, a few days ago, we had
a walk.
Yes,
I saw the pictures.
We had a breast cancer awareness walk,
mm-hmm,
and the aim of that was to tell people that early detection of breast cancer helps stop the developing cancer or stopping cancer in its track,
mm-hmm,
and it's one of our corporate social responsibilities. It's one of the things we have offered to the locality where we operate. And we went all out. We're dressed in our beautiful apparel.
Yes.
And we're sharing flyers and teaching people to come early for detection. We taught a few members of the public who were around how to go about a breast self-examination, which is what we encourage every woman to know. Then we encourage them to come from an annual screening. So you come for an annual screening to check if you have any lesions in your breasts that could be developing into breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And for women who are 40 and above, we encourage them also to come once a year, annually, to come for a mammography, which is one of the screening tools we use for breast cancer.
Nice.
So Evercare has its role in the clinic, in our everyday clinic. One function of a doctor is educating the patient. In fact, it's one of the pillars, especially for primary care physicians. You want to tell them things they should do. You want to teach them about the right diet. You want to teach them about regular exercise.
Mm-hmm.
You want to teach them about moderation, especially in their lifestyle and work, to reduce stress.
Mm-hmm.
And just encourage them to present early, because we have discovered that we have a very, very poor health-seeking behavior in this part of the world. A patient presents with either a headache or a pain somewhere, his first line of action is to go to a drugstore, or he goes to his pastor.
It's common. He'll say, I have malaria. They say, I'm feeling malaria. Give me malaria tablets.
Or they call their mother at home, or they call their dad at home.
Mommy, that time I was having a headache.
Exactly.
Or what do you call these people? Tri-medical?
Yeah, those ones by the roadside.
Exactly.
Yes. So,
or you see, so those who are not specialists in the areas of treating. And it's so bad that the healthcare practice you find out that you have done so many wrong, you follow the wrong route, you've done so many wrong things before you eventually come
time to do the
to
right
the physician
thing.
Who will guide you on the right thing to do. So these are some of the things we do at Evercare Hospital to help our patients and make them understand the need for preventive medicine and preventive healthcare.
Thank you so much, doctor. Just like Bolao kind of highlighted, he said something about how most people believe that if it's not broken, don't fix it. And to some individuals as well, regular checkups and, you know, regular doctor visitations and all that, you know, jazz could mean a lot of money for them. They always feel like, oh, that's too expensive. So he's telling me to go to the doctor, even if I'm not feeling fine, I should go and be checking myself. Is it not expensive? But is preventive medicine cost-effective?
It is absolutely cost-effective. Absolutely cost-effective. it's no-brainer that it's cost-effective. Let us take cervical cancer, for example.
Mm-hmm.
All you need to come do to see if you've started developing cervical cancer is to do a screening, a pap smear.
Mm-hmm.
That will tell you whether you have cells developing or not. And if you do not, you are given protection. You are given a vaccine, especially after you've been tested for...
I like the idea of this vaccine. It's like it combats everything.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It boosts your health, your immune system.
It's I call it a preventive bullet.
Mm.
It protects you against that. As against when you have developed full-scale cervical cancer. If you see a patient who has come down with a CA, it's a horrifying and a horrific sight. Yes. You can't even... The patient is in pain. The patient looks very sick.
Mm-hmm.
The patient has an offensive smell.
Yes, I know.
And it impacts on every aspect. The dynamics of the family, the community. If the person is a breadwinner of that family, that impacts as well on what would have happened to the kids or to the wife.
Mm.
So preventive medicine, its relevance can never be overstated. It's actually cheaper than taking care of yourself when you have come down with an illness. For me, it makes more sense to use insecticide-treated nets to prevent malaria than to come down with malaria
and
start taking treatments.
Drugs.
All right. Thank you so much, Doctor. We're totally out of time.
Yes, we are. And I, unfortunately, I just need you to take this message because this is from Obi. And she goes, considering the effects of radiation on cancer cells, how can you explain the benefits of a mammogram for females in preventing cancer?
Yes. And thank you for your question. That was why I specifically said, before you are even asked to do a mammogram, the mammogram is not for every female. The mammogram is for a female who is above 40 and who has other features that are suggestive of a breast cancer. I talked about you being able to do a breast self-exam. So every female is supposed to know how to do that. And the whole idea of being able to do your breast self-exam is so that when you start noticing changes, you'll be able to pick it up early. So for women who are less than 40, we recommend an ultrasound scan, which doesn't come with radiation. So the whole idea is you being able to pick this disease early. For me, it is better I'm exposed to the radiation to know if I have a disease than to come down with the disease. Besides, the doses of this radiation comes in very, very, very minute quantity that wouldn't pose any form of harm, except you repeatedly go that. And that's why we recommend it. Every year, it's a recommendation that it's done annually. So in Evercare Hospital, it's something we will not guide you to do something that will be deleterious to your health.
We'll
guide you in the right path.
Very true.
So we recommend patients to come for our wellness check, and the Evercare Wellness and Health Clinic has packages for all caterers or all strata of people in the society.
Mm.
We have the plan for the basic, we have the intermediate, we have the comprehensive, we have the advanced package, we have the advanced plus. It's a package that
fits all categories.
Exactly. And it's designed in such a way that it will suit your age, it will suit your sex, it will suit whatever presenting illness or whatever pre-morbid condition you have or existing medical condition you have. So I enjoin our listeners to encourage prevention and to come around to seek healthcare even when they are well. This is when we encourage people to come. I don't want to see a patient that is unable to walk, that is groaning in pain.
It's a good thing we always say from the get-go that prevention is better than cure.
Exactly.
But real quick, though, I'm sure that the our listeners out there would love to know where Evercare is, and also they'd love to know how to reach out to you. So how can the good people of Lagos, listening and around the world, reach out to you and, of course, Evercare Hospital?
Well, Evercare Hospital is located in here in Lagos. It's I'll give you the address. It's on number 1 Admiralty Way, off Bisola Duro Simieti Drive, Lekki Peninsula Phase 1, here in Lagos. And the website for the hospital is www.evercare.ng. For listeners, you can call in these numbers to reach, and any of your complaints or concerns will be addressed. 081-398-50710. I'll take that again. 081-398-50710. You can also reach us through our email, info@evercare.ng.
All right. Thank you so much,
Thank
Doctor.
Thank you so much, Doctor, for
it's
that.
It's been a pleasure. It's been a real pleasure sharing with, having you discuss with us everything that's related to preventive medicine, amongst other things. If you just joined the show, you've missed a ton of good stuff already. Dr. Enaholo Odia is our very special guest today. And, of course, he's a consultant family physician with Evercare Hospital, Lekki. This has been the Smooth Health Show. And there's more to come, Lagos.
Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed. Stick around. Coming up inside of 6 o'clock hour is going to be plenty of good music. And of course, 7 o'clock, our special guest will join us in there to talk about more music. Stay with us.
Smooth Health on the Drive.
It's a global observation that helps raise people's awareness.
Every Thursday at 5:15 p.m.
If you didn't know, now you know.
Powered by Evercare Hospital, Lekki. Transforming healthcare in Nigeria. Smooth Health on the Drive.
It's a global observation that helps raise people's awareness of
health information and tips for optimal well-being.
How to prevent it, detect or treat
every
it.
Thursday at 5:15 p.m.
So Lagos, if you didn't know, now you know.
I bet you think this is going to be one of those ads where someone says, introducing, to sell some new improved product to you.
But we feel there are more important things in life, like driving carefully on rainy days to avoid splashing water on pedestrians.
Or stopping to help someone change a flat tire.
Because what really matters is being the change.
Lipton Yellow Label Tea. Awaken to what really matters.
Win amazing prizes like a paid trip to Dubai for two, PS5, mobile phones, ACs and laptops in the ongoing Premier Cold Chill and Win promo running from 2nd August to 30th October. Just text your unique code to 1393. Terms and conditions apply.
With Airtel Home Broadband device, your home is connected and you all can focus on the important things in life. Enjoy the finer things in life in the Airtel HBB seasonal offer. Visit any certified Airtel shop to get a 4G MiFi at 9,999 Naira plus up to 55 gigabyte bonus data, or router at 19,999 Naira plus up to 160 gigabyte bonus data. Offer valid while stock lasts. Terms and conditions apply.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yo, mic check.
Get the tea on today's trending stories on the top 5 at 5.
Let's get it going.
Hey!
Everything from hot gossips to breaking trends, information, and more.
More.
So much.
much to talk about.
Ladies and gentlemen,
so little time.
Rewind, say it again.
Catch the top five at five on the Smooth Drive every weekday from 5 p.m. Hey, hey. Only on 98.1.